Hi everyone, I'm Latasha from websitesetup.org, and today I'm bringing you a tutorial on creating an online store with Shopify. So before we hop into that, here's a bit more about us. So websitesetup.org is a free online resource for learning web development, design, and WordPress. And our goal is to help beginners create their own websites, blogs, and online stores using the right tools and platforms. To learn a bit more about our review policies and processes, be sure to click the link in our description box, or you can go ahead and visit websitesetup.org. So first off, what is Shopify? Shopify is a subscription to a software service that allows you to create a website and use their shopping cart solution to sell, ship, and manage your products. Shopify offers a 14-day free trial, and for a monthly subscription, you can build a fully functional online store that you can use to sell digital or physical goods. So to get started, simply head over to shopify.com and use the sign up form to create an account. After entering your email address, click the Start Free Trial button, and you'll also be asked if you have products, and if so, what they are. If you're just trying out Shopify to see if it works for you, you can select I'm just playing around in the Do you have products field. And after you've signed up, you'll be directed straight to your store admin screen, where you'll be able to start customizing your store, uploading products, and setting up payments and shipping. Now, when it comes to themes, Shopify has its own official theme store. These themes are all guaranteed to have full support from the designers, so you can rest assured knowing that your store is in good hands. All themes come with a comprehensive list of modifications you can make without having to touch a line of code, which is great. So the premium themes come with a bit more modifications, but you can also achieve a great looking site with a free one. Now, if you want to make larger changes to a theme, there are very few limitations on what can be achieved by accessing the HTML and CSS. Shopify also has an international team of design agencies that they call their Shopify experts, and you can hire them to fully customize your site. To find a theme that suits your needs, go ahead and browse the theme store over at themes.shopify.com. There, you'll find over 70 variations to choose from, including a good selection of free ones. Now, to preview the theme in action, go ahead and click View Demo. Once you find a theme that you like, click the button. Now, don't worry if you're not 100% sure if it's the right fit for you, because you can always go back and change your theme later. After the template has installed, Shopify will let you know, and it'll give you the option to go to your theme manager. To make edits to your theme, select Themes from the left navigation menu of your admin screen. On this page, you'll see your live theme in a box at the top, and in the top right corner of that box will be two buttons. The second button says Customize Theme. If you click on that, you'll be taken to a page that controls all the basic functionality of your store. This is a great time for you to have a thorough play with the settings and test out all of the different features so you can find out what your site is capable of. Now, the most common features generally include uploading logos, uploading slides to a homepage carousel, adding related item functionality to product pages, choosing how many items appear on each line of the collection pages, color schemes, and fonts. So what is a store without products, right? Using the left-hand navigation bar, go ahead and select products and then choose add a product. Use the following screen to add as much detail as needed about your products. Pay special attention to elements that will affect SEO or search engine optimization, like name, description, and URL. This is also the screen where you'll upload your product pictures. And once the images are uploaded, you can always rearrange them, so don't worry too much about getting them in the right order or uploading them in any particular way when you first start. Another thing you can do is set up collections or groups of products. Products can appear in any number of collections, and arranging them this way helps customers find what they're looking for a little bit easier. And before getting your site live, you'll need to do just a few additional key things. You'll need to set up your payment gateways, share tax and shipping details, and enter in a little bit more information about your company. A payment gateway allows you to take payment from your customers, which is very important. Payment gateway transaction fees are added on top of Shopify's own transaction fees, so check out the full article that goes along with this video. We'll link it in the description box. That way you can see a breakdown of the costs. Next thing, you'll need to make sure that all of your business information is filled out in the bottom left section of the settings area. The Google Analytics feature can also prove to be an invaluable source for tracking your store visitors, so don't forget to set that one up. To set up your taxes, go to the products section of your main admin panel, click on the name of a product, scroll down a little bit, and make sure that the checkboxes next to charge taxes and requires shipping are checked if you need to include these with your products. Now, not all stores will need to charge for both of these things. Digital goods, for example, usually don't require tax or shipping, but a t-shirt company, on the other hand, would likely need to check both boxes. Now, lastly, you'll want to test your order system. So to test your system, you can simulate a transaction using Shopify's bogus gateway system. We have a step-by-step tutorial on this in the corresponding blog post, so go ahead and click over in the description box if you'd like to check that out in detail. And finally, once you've confirmed everything is working, you'll need to add a domain name. You can either buy one from Shopify to have it get added automatically. This is usually pretty affordable. It generally ranges from about $9 to $14 per year, or you can purchase from a third-party domain like GoDaddy. Now, if you do that, you will need to connect it to your Shopify site, which we also detailed in that blog post. So detailed instructions for that over on our site. And that's it. If you followed these steps, you should now have a fully working online store. If you'd like more details on this process or to read up on some alternatives, be sure to head over to our website, websitesetup.org. Thanks so much for watching. And of course, be sure to leave us a comment and let us know how you're liking Shopify down in the comments below. We'll see you next time. Bye.